Hello and welcome to another video. A couple of days ago, Osmond had announced that they had added a new layer to their app, which shows running routes. And neither do I run, nor do I have an iPhone, because it's only for the iPhone app. But I'll show you how to map a running route anyway. So this is what it looks like on your phone. It's down here. They have fitness trails and running routes, and then you can enable them, and that should show them on the map, if they are mapped, that is. So that's why I'm showing you how to do that. So I went into Kilkenny Castle Park and walked around the running route and took a GPS trace. And of course, because it's me, I took a wrong turn again, because even when I'm walking a running route, I take wrong turns. So I had to do two traces. But this is it here. And I do have the Irish there saved, but it didn't do the FADAS, which is a bit annoying. I'll figure it out. I've prepared all the tags here. That should do it. So these are the tags you need for your relation. Type running. The name is Kilkenny Park Run, and there are park runs in major town cities as well, apparently. There's a website for it as well. It's parkrun.ie, and the color of the longer one is blue, and it's a round trip because you can run several rounds to make up the kilometers you need, because the Castle Park is big, but it's not that big if you're into running. And the symbol is a blue arrow, and it's a one way because it's well, you can run it the other way around as well, but you can only see the arrows one way. And then I added this website. So these are the tags we're going to need. And I click on this one first, you see that it's kind of a loop. And I click on Edit Map to open the ID editor. It starts here somewhere, here. There's an entrance here into the Castle Park. But you can really start it anywhere because it is a round trip. So I walked clockwise, and I think that's the way you're supposed to do it. So we'll just we'll start with this one here because it's an approach, and that is important too. So I have to create a new relation, obviously, and I click under relations. I click here and on new relation, and under route features, I hope there is running. There isn't. So I'm just going to click on walking. Go down here and change the route from foot to running. And then we're still creating the new relation. I click on the text icon to change into the text mode, and then I can copy what I have here. This should have been route running. And I'll just copy these ones that are correct under here. And change into the table or list mode again. And operator is probably, it's either Sport Ireland or Kilkenny County Council. I don't know, it's not really not that important. This footpath though is not part of the run, it's the approach, and that's the role you can give it. So just type in approach. And then we're gonna start adding the actual running route. Let's just highlight this and see if it just goes round and round and round. No, I'll split that here because that's the starting point. I don't really have to. And see how far this goes. So this goes around here, around the lawn in front of the castle, but the actual running route goes around here. That's where I got lost, where it didn't turn right. So I'll split it here again. And we'll just start with this bit here of the footpath and add that to the newly created creation, which is Route Kilkenny Park Run, and the role is main. And then we have a marker here to the right of the running trail, and we use the trail marker. So you can either type in trail marker at the top here or use this combination. But typing it in is much easier. If you're using JOSM, you can use a preset for that. So this one is So the main route, the longer round goes all the way around, but the shorter one turns here. And I walk the longer one. So I can add the color blue is the longer one and red is the shorter one. The material of the tray marker is that recycled plastic that I mentioned before. It's everywhere now. So plastic. And add that to the root as well as root marker. And then it goes around here. Main. And there was a map here that showed the route, so I'll add that to the relation as well. And you can tag that or give that the role of information. And continue here. For some reason there was no, or I didn't see a trail marker here, even though there are a lot of options. But I think you're supposed to turn right here. So I'll add that as main. And then I have to split it off here. I should have checked before, because this is not the park run. So I split this footpath off that isn't part of it and just delete it from the relation again. And then instead it goes this way. Main, and then we have another trail marker here. And this one is only blue, that's why I put in blue in the description when I used Osmond to map it. Plastic, and add it to the relation as a root marker. And then I have to split this footpath here as well, because it's only this part that is part of the relation. Yeah, that's probably the last bit actually for the blue relation. So I'll add that. Parkrun main, and just make sure I have all the trail markers. I'll just delete that again and copy this one here. And not to forget to add it to the relation as well. Root marker. To continue on here, I also added some of the pathways that hadn't been added already. And then this crossing here, this is for both the blue one and the red one. So I have to add red here. Oops, red. And the red route goes across here, but I'll have to map that separately in the new relation because I'll get confused if I don't. Then there's one here. I'll leave that out for now because it's only for the red one. It says 4 kilometers. I think you have to run at least 3 rounds to get to 4 kilometers for that. Then there's one here, a blue one. And it says 1 kilometer, so I'll add inscription 1 kilometer. Oh, and add it to the relation. And then there's another one here that is blue and says 3 kilometers, which is the distance between the two is certainly not 2 kilometers. But I'm sure people who run this regularly know how to use this. Goes around here. This is all okay. So that really long footpath ended there, and then I have to add this bit. Oops, no. Main. And that's where we started off. So I could also add another approach here because we have the loop finished now, but I'd say you could also start coming into the park here. So we'll add that as another pro. I don't know how people get into the park to start their run. There are a couple more approaches, but I'm not sure if they're all trail marked. So that should be it, really. I'll save that. Added new running route relation. Hashtag. It might be under trail companion, maybe not, I don't know. Source GPS. That should be it. And upload that. This won't show anything here because it's a relation, but I will go here and get the name so we can run an overpass search and click on wizard. Name equals Kilkenny Park Run, and it has to be in quotes. And I'll click on build query and zoom in on Kilkenny. And I can delete the first two lines as usual because we're only looking for the relation. I'll wait a little bit longer because... So let's try running this query. And there it is. So it looks complete. Yeah, and we have the two approaches and the trail markers. And if I click on it, it gives me the information that I've just put in, and I will go and add the red one as well now, and then we have them all on OpenStreetMap, and they should show on your Osmond iOS version if you activate that layer, and then you can go and run for it. And there are more, there's apparently one in Carlow as well, and I'm sure they're in a lot of towns and cities. So thank you for watching. And I hope you found this helpful. If you did, please go and add another running trail, not a personal one that you've run yourself or that you run regularly yourself, but it has to be trail marked. So it has to have trail markers and maps around. For anything else, you can use the usual suspects like All Trails. And like and subscribe to the channel and share with your friends, of course. And see you in the next one. Slán!